guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're new here, my name is Vijaya, and if you're returning, what's up? What's up? Thank you for joining me here today. So today I want to share with you guys some of the ways or some of the things that you can check out when you're going to buy your concealer. These are the things that you can use to spot an original concealer over a fake concealer, or a fake concealer over an original concealer. So on my hands I have all these concealers. I don't have so many concealers because I only use one shade of concealer. Out of these four concealers, one is fake, okay? And if you're not keen enough, you will not be able to spot a fake Elegal Pro concealer if you are not keen enough. I have all the key points or all the key things that you need to check out when you're buying your concealer. So one of the first things that you need to check is the size. These two concealers are Elegal Pro concealer, but one is fake and the other one is original. But how do you know that one is fake and the other one is original? So you mean you can't even tell like which one is original and which one is fake? Can you? You know, the number one thing that you need to check is the size. I know some of you probably had seen the font and all those things, but you didn't even think about the size. So this is the original concealer. It is very, very small as compared to the fake concealer, which is bigger in size. Looking at them side by side, this one is bigger than this one. Clearly, this is the fake one and this is the original one. Now that's one thing to check out when you're buying your concealer, okay? Your Elegal Pro concealer, to be specific, Elegal. Another thing that you need to check out is the lid of the concealer. Now, look at these two concealers and look at the lids. This is the original concealer. So look at its lid. You see, these lines are very long as compared to the lines on the fake concealer. That's very easy. Like, that's one easy thing to check out when you're buying a concealer. You know, when it comes to size, unaweza changanyikiwa and you're like, I feel it's bigger, I feel it's smaller. So, you know, when you don't have one, you don't have a fake concealer to compare with. So what you need to check out is the lid. Like, the lid of the original concealer has very elongated lines or stripes, whatever those are, as compared to the ones on the fake concealer. So check out the lid. Number three is the fonts of the writing of these two concealers. That is very, very easy to check out, okay? So let's start off by checking the Elegal writing of this concealer on top here. This is actually the original concealer. Look at the writing of the Elegal. It's popping, it's there, it's living, it's just showing off, like it's not hiding anything. And then on top of that, it has a trademark. There's like a trademark thing going on here. Now let's check the fake concealer. Look at the writing of the fake concealer. This is fake. The writing is so fake. It's so faded. Like, it's so, a trademark isn't there. The other thing that you need to check is the writing around here. You see this writing around here. Compare it with the writing of the original concealer. Like, this one has some weight, it has some color, it's just showing off, like it's there, you can actually read it from a distance. Like, you at home, I know you can read this writing around here, but when it comes to this one, if you try and read, you can't, clearly you can't. Now let's go ahead and check at the place where we have the what? The shade. So this is where we have the shade fawn, and actually my fake concealer is also supposed to be in fawn. My thing is, I just did like this and the shade rubbed off, like it's just so fake. So when you look at my original concealer, you have your original, you have your shade here. Like, you rub it however you want, not unless, I don't know what you can do. Like, you just can't rub it off using your finger like the way you can rub off the font, the shade of the fake one, and then it just comes out. So when it comes to the original one, you can't do that. It's just there to stay. Another thing to note, the sticker that carries the shade carries the barcode as well, you know, the expiry date and all that. So once you decide to peel this sticker, you just peel all this together. But now when it comes to the fake one, the sticker of the shade is here. This is the sticker of the shade that was existing here. It's actually placed separately with the barcode and the expiry date. Look at the place where we have expired it. We do not have batch code number. Yeah, when you look at the original concealer, where we have the expired date, we have batch code number thingy going on there, you know. Now that you have checked all around the concealer, let's go ahead and open these concealers and then let's talk what is inside. So because my original concealer, I haven't used it yet, let me grab the one that I've been using. This is the concealer that I've been using for a while. It's actually an original concealer in the shade fawn, and remember, our fake concealer is also supposed to be in the shade fawn, but the shade rubbed off. So when you open them, they look alike. The original one as a brush and the fake one as a brush. I was actually surprised that this Elegant Pro Concealer that I was sold was actually fake, because it didn't occur to me that fake concealers come with a brush. But anyway, it's fake and this is original, and they all have brushes. So the fake one has a very choking smell, a very chemical-ish choking smell. Like, the smell is just the first thing you get to ear when you open it, to be honest. When you open this concealer, the first thing that you get to hear is the smell. And it smells so bad. Like, these are just too many chemicals mixed together and very much unprocessed. Love yourself. When it comes to this one, the original one, it has a smell. The smell is there, but it's not a very choking smell like this fake one has. Like, the smell is there, but not unless you smell it. That's when you can get to smell it. But it doesn't choke you. It's there and it's good. It actually smells something cosmetic, you know, something really, really nice and good for use. So the other thing that I want, and actually the last thing that I want to show you guys, is the consistency of these two concealers. Like, how do you use this concealer to even, this concealer is so thick. Anyway, look at the consistency of this original concealer. Now let's press this one. You look at them for yourself. Look at these two concealers. Look at these two concealers. Like, look at how this thing is thick. This is the original concealer and this is the fake one on this side. This is a fake one and this is the original one. The consistency is very visible if you check them clearly. Like this one is just so thick and this one is just, you know, it just shows some smoothness, you understand? And yeah, so this is the last thing that I get to share, and I'm so happy to have shared all these things. I have been a victim of fake concealers for such a long time, and it's because I didn't probably have the knowledge that I have right now. And yeah, so if you have learned something, go and share it with someone that, you know, doesn't know thing. They've probably been using the wrong concealers. So yeah, help them know how to check out the details that I've shared with you guys on spotting an original concealer over a fake concealer, or a fake concealer over an original concealer. That's all for today. I hope you've learned something in this video. And also, if you have an idea or you have a tip on how to spot a fake concealer that I haven't shared, go ahead and let me know in the comment section below. And yeah, so see you guys on my next video. Bye.